Hello everyone, hi, this is Neelam, back to my channel again. I guess I'm posting after a long time. So as I said, I usually post when I feel really urged or really compelled to do a question. And today the question that I'm doing is on request by Tina, who had written to me I think 3-4 days back. Hey Tina, big shout out, hi, this is for you. I hope you're able to get a message while you watch this. Also, others, I hope that my readings are resonating with you, and I hope I'm able to bring in messages for you always. So please let me know in the comment section if my messages are bringing you some clarity or are they guiding you or not. So also guys, with all of this happening in the world, please stay safe. This is in regards to the coronavirus alert that is there all throughout the world. I hope all of you are doing well and are safe. Make sure that you are doing the right things and you are taking care of yourself, because that is the most critical thing for anybody. All right, so okay, so coming back to tarot and the question that we are doing today, the question is, are you destined to be with them? So are you destined to be with your person or not? I will try to figure this out for you. Usually this is a question that is there in everyone's mind, if you are in a relationship or not, irrespective of that. We always tend to think if this will work out or not, whether this will manifest or not, or this will happen or not. So I wanted to check, and a lot of my clients have been asking this question, so let's see if these cards are able to tell you if you are destined to be with them. This is a very sweet personal question, and I am very happy to do this reading as well for all of you. So as you can see, I have three piles here. This one is number one. This is the black obsidian. Number two is the clear quartz. And the third pile is the red jasper. Okay. Pile one, pile two, and pile three. So you can pause the video, meditate over the question, think of your person. I don't want you to be distracted while you're choosing the pile. So if you're watching this, please watch it when you are not surrounded by anything else. Think of the question, think of the person, and then choose one pile. I'll wait for, say, 30 seconds for you to do that. All right, let's begin with pile number one, the black obsidian. Give me a moment while I put these aside for you. Okay, I hope you can see the cards clearly, because I want you to have a look at the cards and then proceed further. Okay, so this is your pile number one, the black obsidian. Okay, here's the crystal. First card is a leg up. Surrender to trust. Mermaid's love. Six of swords. Ten of Wands. Okay. All right. So are you destined to be with this, with them or with your person? Okay. It's a tough journey, guys. Whoever has chosen this pile, please tell me if this is resonating with you. This is not easy. I'm seeing one of you has been very, very patient, has been trying his or her level best to not give up or to not lose hope at all in this situation. You are trying your level best, and this connection is a lot about unconditional love. I see the mermaid's love, which can be a little illusionary at times, but I do sense that there is this element of unconditionality here. I do feel that the feminine in this connection has been giving a lot and has been standing by all of this and has been able to succeed, is still hopeful. I'm seeing does trust that this will happen. So are you destined to be with them? I see that your angels are working on it. Your spirit guides, your angels are kind of taking you to that path. They are, with this a leg up card. This is a partnership card for me. All right. So it also brings in the message that if you are trying really hard to make something happen, you need to stop and think, because it's a two-way traffic. All right. This will happen. I do see that this will happen. All right. But you need to let your person come on the same page as you. You can't be the only one. So this is a general reading. The characters can be vice versa. So please take what resonates. So I would talk to you, whoever is watching this. So I feel that this is you. You cannot be the only person in this relationship who is just giving. You cannot be that. All right. You have to understand that a relationship is about balance. It's about being equal. Trust yourself and your decisions. Don't be swayed by other people's strong opinions about what to do. Take action and be confident that you have chosen the right path. Yes, you are on the right path, but you need to also understand that unconditional love is good, but it can't go on to a partnership if it is only one-sided. All right, there has to be equal reciprocation, and I do see that happening pretty soon. All right, so you are destined to be with this person. I think people who've chosen this pile, you are fretting over it, you are very anxious. Okay, you are very anxious. At times, maybe you just question that, is this even real? Is this even happening? What is happening? Is this all in my mind? No, it's not in your mind. It is there. It is there. This connection is pretty much real. It is there. But there is a time for everything. All right. And here it's pretty much about timing. It's a lot about timing. All right. This partnership is sacred. This partnership is beautiful, and this partnership will happen. I'm seeing that. This partnership is divinely guided, no doubt about that. But you cannot keep being impatient. You cannot keep being the only one giving. Stop. I would suggest that you should stop putting in so much of effort and so much of hard work into making this happen. I sense that a lot of you who've chosen this pile are just disturbed. You just keep thinking that, what should I do that maybe this time reduces? Maybe he or she just comes to me. What should I do? You need to calm down. You need to detach from this feeling for a bit, because you being anxious or you wanting this to happen fast will not make it happen that way. You need to relinquish control. You need to let go of the feeling of making this happen as soon as possible. All right. I do see this. I do see that this connection will stand the test of time, because it is a partnership. But as you see in this picture, one is a full-grown bear, the other one is a small one. So I sense that one of you is not, like, it hasn't come in equilibrium with each other at the moment. You have to let it come to that point. Only then can a stable and a balanced relationship exist. All right? So you need to relinquish control. Be patient. I'm seeing that you have been patient all this while, but there is anxiety. I do see. There is a lot of unconditional love, which is good. But you need to trust the universe. All right? And it will happen in its own time. As I said, that one person in this connection is still not as mature or as evolved / spiritually grown as the other one. So you both will have to reach that same level, and only then will this manifest. So yes, this is a positive reading. It will happen, guys. It will happen. Trust. Surrender to trust. Yeah. Okay, so that's what I have for pile number one, Black Obsidian. Personal reading details are given in the description. And if you want a personal reading, you can pretty much reach out to me there. The slots are open now. Initially, I had a lot of bookings, so I wasn't taking personal readings. But now they're open, so you can reach out to me. And you can follow me on Instagram as well, and I'll move to pile number two. Here's your pile number two, guys. Hope you can see the cards. This is the clear quartz. Yeah. Message in a bottle. Surrender to the magic of who you are. Eva. Three of Pentacles. Six of Wands. Okay. So are you destined to be with this person? Okay, so I feel this pile is a lot about self-love, okay? I am seeing that both of you, like the two of you, are working on it together, okay? I do see it, and there are small victories happening here and there, all right? There are small victories happening, which is very exciting, which is very good, okay? But I do see that there are a lot of other obstacles that are playing a role over here in your relationship. But I do see that, you actually don't need to watch this reading because you already know it. Whoever has chosen this pile, clear quartz, you guys already know that this will happen. You have been receiving a lot of signs, synchronicities from the universe that this connection will happen. So surrender to the magic of who you are. You have pretty much, I am getting the card magician in front of me for some reason. So I feel that whoever has chosen this pile, you guys have pretty much manifested this in your life. All right, you have. Now you need to trust it. You have to trust in the magic of who you are. Okay, we all have magic in us, even the mundane aspect of life. Remember that you are a magical being with a uniqueness and worth that come from just being you. All right. I do see that at times you go in a self-sabotage energy with the feeling of thinking that maybe this will not happen. Maybe I don't know where this is going. But I do sense that there is a part of you who just knows that this will happen. And you at times just suppress that thing. Like, you know, just try to ignore it, thinking that this is not real. It's a little similar to pile one. But I'm pretty much seeing that both of you, in fact, even your partner, whoever you have kept in your mind before choosing the pile, even your partner has worked towards it. And they are still working. And this will happen. This will happen. Trust the universe. This will happen. You guys are destined to be together. So whatever is going on right now in this scenario, so it might be different for different people. Whatever is going on in this scenario is a part and parcel of this manifestation. Okay, this will happen. Say if you're going through a period of stagnancy, say there is no movement in this relationship or there is no movement in the connection, okay, it's a part of the process for this to happen. All right, it is a part of it. So you need to understand that anything happening in this relationship at the moment is a part and parcel of coming together. So it's like a journey that is going on. Okay, so trust the universe and the small signs and synchronicities that come your way, which assure you that this is for you. All right? There are going to be other people, there are going to be some distractions which are going to make you feel that no, this is not worth it. There are going to be people of those sort or people or circumstances, because I'm seeing that it's nothing. I mean, if people have chosen this pile, it's not much to do with you both. It is to do with the circumstances. All right. The people around you, I think, which has led to a couple of miscommunications before. Okay. So one advice that is coming very strongly to me for the people who've chosen this pile, do not stop communicating with your partner. Okay, don't. Because that's what is keeping this intact. That's what is keeping this going. So make sure that you are, there is no miscommunication coming between the two of you. All right? And definitely there are innumerable signs and synchronicities from the universe which are coming to you, and you should listen to them. All right? And this is pretty much destined to happen. Okay. I think pile one and pile two, both have been pretty positive. This is like a very nice reading. I genuinely see that it's like step one, step two, step three, which is leading the two of you together. It's that sort of an energy for this pile. Yeah. Okay, so that's what I have for number two, clear quartz. Please let me know if this resonated. Private reading slots are open, so you can reach out to me. I had shut down initially because there was a lot flowing in, so now you can. Details are there in the description, so you can reach out to me and I'll move to pile number three. Okay, let's see what's gonna happen for number three. This is the red jasper. This is already a color of immense passion. I have been starting to like red. I don't know why. Okay, the first card is why. Surrender the habit of pleasing people. Flower spirit. Ten of swords. Five of wands. Okay. So for this pile, what I am sensing is that now it's not about destiny. It's about what you want. All right. I think you already know, people, whoever has chosen this pile, you guys already know that it is here. There are some stereotypical thinking. There are some, you know, I sense that there are certain chains that have to be broken now because it's time. You guys, both of you have been in an energy of just pleasing people all throughout and maybe just living for others and not living for yourself. Both of you, I think, not only you, but your partner as well. So now is the time to question why. So destiny has, I think, pretty much got things in front of you now that yes, you guys can do this. But I think there is some kind of a decision that has to be taken now. Okay? There is some kind of a fight. There is some kind of a breaking free that needs to happen. Okay? You need to embrace your happiness. Both of you. Whoever has chosen this pile. Both of you need to embrace your happiness and stop the habit of pleasing people. Speak your needs and be true to yourself. Focus on your own happiness instead of always trying to make everyone else happy. So I don't know how many people are resonating with it, but that's the energy that I got immediately from this pile. Right now is actually the time to, you know, whatever is happening at this stage, if you see this card, this is a very deep card. If you see this person is trying to reach out to a book which has angel wings, which is going to answer his or her questions as to why have I been doing all this, this all this while? I mean, why did I always surrender to pleasing people? Why? Why did I not live for myself? You are in the process of questioning. You have, I mean, with look at this card, Ten of Swords. It's like this person has tied himself up and has been taking in all sorts of BS, basically, has been taking in all sorts of anxiety and pressure and everything just so that others are happy. Maybe at this stage, at the cost of his own happiness. But now you need to fight this. Now is the time to break free from this. You need to break certain stereotypical ways of thinking. You need to live for yourself now. So it's not about destiny. It's about decision now. Are you willing to do this? Are you willing to break free? Are you willing to surrender to the habit of pleasing people? The choice is yours now. You wanted love, you wanted it, now it's in front of you. Now, what do you want to do? Do you want to still live in this? Because there are some things that you have to do on your own. Do you still want to live in this? Or do you want to break free and chase what has been your dream? I think what's ahead is your dream. I would want to pull some more cards for this. What's ahead? Yes. Yes, I do see that what's ahead is a very nurturing, loving relationship for the two of you. But are you willing to accept this cup of love that has come from the universe to you? Are you willing to do that? That's a bigger question. Are you willing to take the risk? Are you willing to live for yourself? Do you have that capacity? Do you have that courage to do this? I do see that you are in a zone of questioning. I do see that. You are questioning everything. You are wanting reasons. You want answers. You want to understand everything. I think both of you, it's not only your energy, whoever's watching this, it's for both of you. I sense that both of you are in this energy of figuring things out. Why, what, when. But this is pretty much it. Now it's your task. Now you are the only one, both of you in fact, who can take this forward. The universe has done what it has to do. It has brought the right person at the right time in your life. Now it's your call. Pretty intense pile this was, number three. Yes. Okay, so let me know in the comments if this resonated with you guys. For private readings, you can reach out to me. I would be happy to take them up right now because initially I didn't have the bandwidth, so now I do. That's pretty much it. I will see you soon again with another reading. Let me know in the comments if my readings resonated with you, and I'll be back soon for you with another reading. Till then, have a safe day ahead, and please guys, keep yourself safe and keep yourself happy.